by 9 o'clock to car 8. It's a fantastic clear. We're going to get right up close to the Susitna River. You're off to the left.
I'm going to go on the ground. Doesn't seem too bad, does it? Denali National Park. Bottom of Mount McKinley, Denali. Yeah, the top's covered with clouds. That's the base of it. We are in Denali National Park with Matt. We just hiked supposedly a mile, but more like 2.5 miles. There's some things in there. And we're supposed to come to this mining camp up here, but we kept going up and up and up, and we never find a way to get in. So we're gonna turn around. old mine, abandoned mine. There's McKinley's over that way somewhere, right?
Yep. McKinley would be the lowest part of these hills right here.
Yeah.
In that area.
Another day. Because there's still more mountain above that.
Have Alder where you live?
No.
Well, this is the mountain alder, and this is the only wood that's used to smoke salmon on the Yukon River by the indigenous people, the Yupik, Eskimo, as well as the Athabascan Indians. But they'll be smoking with alder wood on the custom equipment, as well as the Yukon and any other tributary. So it looks like there might be enough for everyone, but off to the right here, we've got a good cluster of blueberries here. So feel free to grab some of those. I think it's definitely one of my favorite flowers. And it's one thing that you see when you're driving down any highway in Alaska. It's always on the sides of the road. It's always growing on gravel roads. It's one of the first things to sprout up anytime you have any ground disturbance, whether you're new construction, moving a bunch of trees out of the way, or there's been a fire that's happened. It's going to be sprouting. That's why it gets the name fireweed. Both obviously from because of its color, but also because it's the first thing to sprout up after a fire.
And that was put in at a later date.
So we got the key. We can go inside and check it out. Everything original except for the floor. There was a flood several years back, and the Park Service had to replace the floor. And they also filled the cellar. There used to be a cellar, but they filled it.
There they are.
Now it's a one bedroom, no bath. There's an outhouse out the back. Even this floor mat's original. Look in this this picture right here. That floor mat, that's right, the same floor mat that's sitting out here.
Oh yeah, there it is right
here. Huh. Yeah, that hallway, that's where the sun
sandwich. Listen to the peacefulness. Very quiet. Occasional fly. Bird. Can hear the river off in the background. It's very peaceful and quiet. This is what the tundra looks like. It's very soggy right here. It's usually very spongy, but next to the lake it's very soggy. It's kind of sink down into it. Permafrost is just below the surface, about a foot, which apparently never melts. Trying to grow. Two of them actually. There's another side of beaver pond. Let's check through the tundra a little bit. See any sign of fish in the pond? That's where I was sitting just a little while ago, right back next to that tree there. Big one in the middle. Ain't much better than this, not a human manufactured noise anywhere around except my voice. Matt at Denali Backcountry Lodge. Just got back from
Wonder Lake.
Wonder Lake,
where it was back in the world, it was raining
like it has been all week.
That's right. It's been beautiful weather out here.
And that's where Matt works, right over there in the main lodge. He's a GSR guest service representative.
That's right. GSR hero.
That's right. Cabins over here for the guests. I got a screen porch and an outdoor porch. This is Moose Creek. That's a Kantishna air taxi up on the hill. path behind the stream. Under the waterfront cabin. This is the day lodge back in the back. People have their lunch and they do presentations in the evening. And this is the suspension bridge. It's the miner's tent. This is the miner's tent inside. This creek here is a separate creek. It's red because it's got such a high iron content. Here's the lodge from the other side. Moose Creek.
Area, nice little stream here. Got a bridge right there in front of my dad, and we're gonna cross that. And
there's the trail.
Go on and continue our journey. See you in a bit.
Denali National Park, McKinley Bar Trail. Because of our late start, because the bus driver decided to change the schedule, we didn't quite make it to the McKinley Bar, but it's probably not too much further. But, we got to turn around because we got a bus to catch. So, but McKinley's not out today anyway, so it really doesn't matter. But it's been a nice hike, pretty area. This is the trail going back up to the Wonder Lake campground. So, nice little stream here. Just notice how quiet it is. Dry creek bed.
There's a rope in. I don't want to be yelling out the windows to scare it away.
Slow ankle.
Hey.
Kann ich keine Schnackschüsse machen mit dem Scheiß Ding.
Oh, they can't be much more than a few years old. They're small little guys. Every move I make, he makes a move. As soon as I stop, he stops. As I roll, he moves.
Oh, he's starting to get his right.
Left side.
He'll jump right on the bus if we don't ignore
him. Left side. Left side.
Some on the left side as well. Oh, yeah, one's at 9 o'clock right on the road. That's the easiest one to take a picture of.
It's like a cross under the bus.
That's a nice one right on the road. 9 o'clock.
Two of them.
These are the chicks. They're getting bigger.
Look at that.
Well, that's what I said. 9 o'clock on the road. You were looking at the 3 o'clock on the road. I was looking at 9 o'clock on the road. Now they're at 10 o'clock.